So a student asked me why in some code that I had in one of my courses were we using .slice when assigning an array to a variable, and here's why. So let's say you have an array and it's stored inside of a variable, so we'll call it R1. And then now you're creating a second variable and you're assigning it to the array that's stored in R1. So you just say R2 is equal to R1. And so now if you look at R1, you have 1, 2, 3, and if you look at R2, you have 1, 2, 3. But now, let's say you go to R1 and you pop the 3 off the end. And so you look at R1 and now all you have is 1 and 2. And you look at R2, R2 is also 1 and 2, but maybe that's not what you wanted. If you want to support devsprout.io, then check out this Chrome extension that I created. You can add it to your browser with the click of a button, and then once it's installed, you can go over to udemy.com. And anytime that you're thinking of buying a course, let's say you're just checking a course out, the extension will notice what you're doing and it'll actually redirect you to the same course page, but it'll add my affiliate ID to the URL. So you can see here, it's added my ID to the URL. And now if you do happen to buy that course, I'll make a small commission off of that sale. So the problem here is that you're assigning R2 to R1, so R2 is not referencing the array, it's referencing the variable that's referencing the array. And so if you change R1, then R2 gets changed as well. And so how do we stop that? So let's go back to our example of R1 is equal to 1, 2, 3. And then R2 is equal to R1.slice. And what will happen here is .slice will create a copy of R1. So if you use .slice without any arguments in it, what happens is it just returns an exact copy of whatever array you called .slice on. So now if you look at R1, we have 1, 2, 3. R2, we have 1, 2, 3. Great, they look the same. Now if we go back to R1 and we pop the 3 off the end, now we look at R1 again, we have 1, 2. And if we look at R2, we still have 1, 2, 3. So if you want to make a copy of another array without affecting the new copy whenever the original gets changed, make sure that you use that .slice method whenever you're assigning it to the new variable.